Hi, this is Sharice Taylor, host of the Facebook page Time Matters. And today I have Ms. Pam Luckie with me. She has a background in the financial service industry over 18 years and a Bachelor's of Science degree in business administration. I thank you so much for taking the time to speak with me about your industry.
Thank you.
So we're going to get into what your role is, if you can tell me a little bit about what your role is in the financial industry and how recent high school graduates or even college graduates can get into this industry, whether they're changing careers or just opportunities that are available.
Okay. I have for 18 years been with the same company, so I really can't speak for the industry, just for my company. The traditional industry usually requires a bachelor's degree in finance or something like that. And then you have a job, you're a salaried W-2 employee. And typically the industry has quotas. You have to attain a certain level and they have you cold calling people. That is not what we do at all. Ours, you need to be 18 years old, have a clean background, because we do have federal and state licenses that are required. It's the professional profession. Where the company I work with is all commission-based. So the beauty of that is you get paid what you're worth. There's no glass ceiling, you're 1099, so the government gets their taxes after everybody else gets their bills paid. We're self-employed, and you work toward being a business owner. I personally work with a marketing company. We market financial products, but I recruit, train, and develop people to be able to own their own business within the company. You can either do it on a part-time or a full-time basis, and you work as much or as little as you want to. It's your choice. It's your 1099. You're not getting paid changing time for money. You're exchanging your actual work access for money.
Okay. And go ahead. I think that's good for people to know that you don't have to be a college graduate to enter into this business.
No, anybody can, as long as they have a willingness, they like people, mm-hmm. and they're willing to learn and be coached.
Okay, and that goes with the qualities. That was going to be my next question. What are the qualities and characteristics that you look for that are needed for people interested in the field?
Obviously, somebody with a good work ethic, somebody that's trustworthy, dependable. I mean, you got to be able to follow through with what you tell people you're going to do. And then just, you know, the willingness to learn and be able to help people.
Wonderful.
The rest of it's a lot.
So that's great. And I've heard that over and over again, to be open and willing to learn. What pearls of wisdom then do you have for parents and families to make the most of their time and even to help their students? Because, you know, we briefly spoke about 17 and 18 year olds making decisions, life decisions on what they want to do. So what pearls of wisdom do you have?
Be open to learn. As you just mentioned, we don't know what we want to do at 17 and 18, and yet we're deciding for the rest of our life if we make a college choice or career choice even. But in terms of what I do, make sure that you understand the foundation of how money works, what the rules of the money game are, and the company I work with leads with education, not transaction-based, but make sure that the consumer is an educated consumer and knows that they can make decisions that are good for them financially in the long run.
Mm-hmm. And especially these days, that's a very big concern, to make sure that you have something to fall back on that you can afford to just maintain your daily living. We're not even talking about the extras. So that's very important. So how do you define success?
Living to your fullest each day, to be able to play your strengths, do what you're naturally good at. A lot of us, that takes some digging and just to be open to figure that out. Mine is to become a better me every day. If I learn something every day, then I'm growing and I'm learning. Unfortunately, most people think that when they finish high school, that school's over. School's over, but learning's not over and education's not over. That's a lifelong process.
That's great. I think that's really great information and wonderful pearls of wisdom there. We covered a lot, and I wanted to know, is there anything else that we did not cover that you want to share or discuss?
The only other thing would be if anybody's interested in any more information about what I have to offer, my email address is pluckie, L-U-C-K-I-E, at Primerica, P-R-I-M-E-R-I-C-A.com. I also have a website that is www.primerica, P-R-I-M-E-R-I-C-A.com/pluckie, L-U-C-K-I-E.
Great. Thank you so much. I appreciate you taking the time to speak with me and to share a little bit about your industry. I think it's important that students and families know that there are a lot of different paths that students can take, regardless whether it's career after high school or college or military, that there are different paths and industries that they can go into. So I really appreciate you taking the time to speak with me. And I always end with, remember, how you spend your time matters. Thank you so much.
Thank you.